విశాఖ అంతర్జాతీయ మహిళా పారిశ్రామికవేత్తల సదస్సులో చర్చా కార్యక్రమం జరుగుతోంది. ఆ కార్యక్రమంలో మార్గదర్శి ఎండీ శైలజ కిరణ్ పాల్గొన్నారు. ప్రత్యక్ష ప్రసారం ద్వారా చూద్దాం.
You know, encourage more women to come into small and medium sector. See, when we talk about coming into small and medium sector, mostly, especially because I work as a social entrepreneur in the rural sector, when we go and train women, they either want to stick to tailoring or they want to do food processing. How do we get them out of this mindset and help them do more than just food processing and garments? Because there's so much more out there. For example, I think manufacturing sector. Today we're talking about industrialization here, which is a very important topic for our conference. How do you think that we can do that?
See, it's so important to know what you're doing. Let's not jump into an area where we are, you know, we are totally unaware of. Because doing business is not easy also. Let us realize that. It's highly competent, there are established players. So I keep saying, you know, try to start local first. Find what is not available in your neighborhood. Or, okay, something is there, it's not up to the standards, then you have a chance to do something better. You got to be the first one or you got to be the better one. So it doesn't matter if you're into garments or if your food is required, garments are required. So that's fine, absolutely. And even in Hyderabad, we have so many boutiques happening in spite of large format stores. So small tailoring units can happen because going big way is not easy also. You got to give day in, day out. It's not going to be happening otherwise. So lots of women talk about work-life balance where they just want to work 3-4 hours and, you know, the rest of the 5-6 hours, 7-8 hours they want it for family. So if that's the way you want it, then it is better the small way, finding your own USP. But if you want to go big way, please study the industry very well, observe what's happening, you know, do your trials at somebody else's expense, go work somewhere, get your knowledge. Find out everything, think 100 times before you put your money. Because it's very difficult to, I don't think I'm being pessimistic, but I'm just saying one has to be very cautious, don't spend all your money at a time, and don't just go big time also, because there's a lot of working capital that is required and it gets very difficult to manage when you put all your money. And then the business doesn't come easily faster. It takes time. So I always believe in growing gradually and steadily, strongly.
I think, like you rightly said, if there are women who, there are a lot of women who want to have a work-life balance, and there are women who want to work just for a couple of hours a day and spend the rest of the time with their families. And I would like to take this opportunity to proudly say that Alif has come up with a Spokane hub model, which actually is making that possible for the women in the rural sector, where they don't neglect their families. They go work for a couple of hours in these incubation centers, make their money, and then go back and spend time with their families. And Ms. Rifa, how do you think associations can bridge the gap between wannabe entrepreneurs, entrepreneurs who are already existing, entrepreneurs who want to expand, and how can you collaborate?